Welcome, everybody. This is the third of four concerts. Can everybody hear me with my mask? Yes? Okay, good. So thank you all for masking. I'm Linda Radke in the church, and this series is put together by three of us, Marty Roberts, Lynette Holmes, and myself. And thank you for coming and also for being generous to the Central Vermont Refugee Action Network. Next week, oh, tonight at 7 o'clock is Nine Lessons and Carols here at Christ Church. Obviously, it's free, but if you would like to bring a donation to the food shelf, that would be great. And next week is our final concert. It's the 23rd of December, and it's early music, the Champlain Consort, and they say at the end they'll be playing Carols of the Season, so maybe we can sing along from our masks. These two ladies have played together for 30 years, and they tell me that the last time was pre-pandemic, so it's a jubilant reunion for Andrea Bartenbeck and Lynette Combs. Let me introduce Hope Criffel from the Refugee Action Network.
Thank you, Linda, and Lynette, and everybody at Christ Church for welcoming the Central Vermont Refugee Action Network here. And I see you. And, sponsoring donations, giving donations to our organization. Central Vermont Refugee Action Network, CVRAN for short, helps people who have made the hard decision to come to the U.S. from Latin America, Eastern Europe, and now Afghanistan. And it's never, as you can imagine, an easy decision, and it's often very dangerous. Depending on their situation, their needs, CVRAN provides transportation, goods, material assistance, housing, and a lot of volunteer support, such as outings, food shopping, education, language, and friendship, especially friendship. Right now, in addition to working with six asylum seekers already in Central Vermont, we're trying to bring an Afghan family here under humanitarian parole, which is different from refugee status. And we're also working with an Afghan refugee family now living in Montpelier. And we're hoping to bring another refugee Afghan family to Montpelier in the near future. Many of these families, as you may know, have 8 or 10 members of a family. So large housing is a crucial need. And if anybody knows of any rental properties, which could have maybe 3 bedrooms, I would love to talk to you. You probably have noticed in yesterday's Times, New York Times, there was an article about the housing crisis for U.S. refugees across the U.S., and Vermont, unfortunately, is no different. We're also in need of hosting situations for asylum seekers. Basically, a host situation provides room, friendship, orientation, kitchen space, and of course, we rely on volunteers, and so volunteers are always welcome. We have a Facebook page and a website, and you're directed there if you want to learn more, or if you want to talk to me or Lauren in the back, we'll be happy to answer any questions. So for the members of CVRAN, I thank you very much. And I'll turn it over to the real performers.
Thank you. Thank you. happy to see you all here. As Linda mentioned, Andrea and I have been playing music together for 30 years, and we're such good friends, musically and otherwise, and it's such a treat to have her here and for us to be playing again for you. You may have known those English folk songs in a different configuration. Many people have loved them and played them. It was originally written for cello and piano, but it works really well with the English horn and the organ, I think. So we'll be moving into the Baroque era right now, and we're going to play three pieces. And since in any concert involving the organ, you just can't get away from J.S. Bach, much as you would like to, we aren't playing any pieces actually written by Bach, but Buxtehude was a big, big influence on Bach, and Bach traveled to hear Buxtehude play and learned a lot from him. And then Handel grew up in the same area of Germany as Bach, and they certainly knew each other. They were born in the same year, so exact contemporaries. And then Ludwig Krebs was a composition pupil of Bach's, and Bach, who liked to make jokes, said, "Krebs is the best crab in the brook." Bach. Thank you.
I'll just say a little bit about this next piece, the Krebs piece. It's one of my absolute favorite pieces anytime, anywhere. And just to let you know what's going on, the oboe has one melody. My right hand has one melody. My left hand has one melody. And then my feet have another melody. So four intertwined melodies. So you can just all melt into your seats while we play. Are you ready yet, Andrea?
I think so.
Okay. Yeah.
composer that's not known very well, Otto Olsson. He was, in his time, the most famous organist in Sweden. But he had studied in France, and he loved the old hymn tunes, what we call plain chant. And so these variations are on a very old hymn from the Christian tradition, Ave Maris Stella. And he also, as you can hear, he liked to draw all the resources of the organ. I'm only playing three variations, but he was influenced by Bach, by his French teachers, all sorts of things like that. And then we're going to finish with another one of my very favorite pieces, a few of the variations from a wonderful piece that Calvin Hampton, an American composer who worked in New York City primarily, wrote back in 1983. Just a little thing to send you on your way on this beautiful day.